start. All right.
Please be seated. State Solicitor.
Yes, my lord. I represent the state on this case.
Very well. You may proceed.
Thank you, my lord. Daniel McLaughlin of 15 Howard Street, Derry, a dapper labourer, is charged with failing to stop when requested to do so by a customs officer. His wife, also in question, Annie McLaughlin, is charged with obstructing a customs officer in the performance of her duty and also attempting to export a quantity of sugar, butter and eggs.
And who is representing this couple?
I am, my lord. This is Authority Defence Solicitor.
Very well, Mr. Kimmelman. Continue.
Unfortunately, my lord, Mr. McLaughlin could not make it here today and has sent his wife.
Mrs. McLaughlin, is there a valid reason for your husband's absence this morning?
Yes, my lord. I have got 10 children, one on a married at the age of 3, so he is at home looking after the children, as both of us could not be here at the same time. My husband was in the habit of taking body today, but for personal use, as we occupied a small house in Fawn and were registered for supplies there.
Thank you. Be seated.
My lord, I call Michael Dawson to the stand.
Raise your right hand. Do you swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth?
I do.
So help me God. Please be seated.
Where were you on the evening of the 31st of October, 1942?
As a punter, that's him, and they're doing 2 years.
And who cycled past you?
Mr. McLaughlin.
Did you ask him to stop?
Yes.
And did he?
No, he did not.
Why did you ask him to stop?
Because his pockets were bulky.
You say you recognised him. How?
I recognised him just before because he was caught stealing £20 worth of butter.
Objections, my lord. You wanted to get that out to prejudice this woman.
I did not ask certain questions in cross-examination. He may not have made that statement.
Lived some months of the year in Fawn, and yet he denies all knowledge of this case.
Very well, I am imposing a £3 fine allowing 1 month for payment. Next case!
I call Ian Callaghan to the stand.
Raise
your right hand. Do you swear to tell the truth,
the whole truth,
and
nothing but the truth?
So help me God.
I do.
Do you recognise the lady in question, Mr. Callaghan?
Yes, I do.
How do you know her?
On the 14th of November, I was searching a train, travelling to Derry from Fawn. I saw that lady in the compartment with a child.
Did she have anything concealed?
I put it to her that she had concealed goods in her, but she denied this.
Did she agree to get searched?
She objected to being searched by a lady searcher, saying that she knew her rights and that she was confronted by a customs officer from Derry to submit not to doing it because it was illegal.
Many members of the public do not understand what the rights of customs officials are.
That's correct.
I understand that there are a lot of people that don't understand the question. Have you experienced any problems when you're searching people on the train?
Yes.
And people in a certain station of life?
The majority submit willing to do it.
And what? Can you explain what did happen?
Can you play with us?
Would you like a wee snuff?
No, not probably.
How about you, no? Maggie, would you take a wee snuff?
Sure,
I'll take a wee snuff. I'm going to put on a pile of spots. I'll see you later, Gert.
Thank you, Rosie.
You're
not surprised.
We're drying the
washer. They're not supposed to be dried. They'll turn it up on there, Paul.
Well, Maggie. If you lend me your washboard, I could get all the washing done today, and it will be dry in no time.
Aye, well, I'm on over now, get it?
That's great. Try to take that tonight, I'll be sending
you any time. It's a pretty good to get me snuff and clear your head.
Lovely.
You sure you wouldn't have an alibi just left over?
I told you there's an enough for your fellow when I can talk to Miss Burke.
Anybody not want their onion? I'll take the onion.
I'm getting hurt.
Lovely,
Mammy.
It's lovely now.
Yes.
Lovely.
That's
nice,
isn't it?
Well, it is lovely. Mammy, I don't want to get out tonight.
Mammy, did we earn a tick, Ellie? Can we get out to play after this?
We'll see after, right? Not promises, nothing else.
I'm not going out because I'm going out for the big boys' day.
Oh. Say what? Tell me, you goody knows.
No, don't
tell me. You're still there.
If you tell, I'll tell a secret you told me.
I never told you anything.
Oh, I did. Remember, I told you. You sure we couldn't get more dinner?
No, there's none left. I told you there's only enough for your power. No. Ellis, did you empty the pot and pot this morning?
Why do I always get all the dirty jobs?
You haven't gone with the swallow, but you have to do it now. And clean you in the dishes.
Okay, Mama.
Right, we're going to say the rosary now, and we're offering it up for your granny who's in hospital. And for Marianne, that she has a wee, or gets a wee message tonight.
I know what her message is. She's getting a baby. Mummy, she told me.
Will you stop that there now?
Mummy, honest, she told me. She told, you did, Peggy, you told me. She told me.
Right, that's
Mummy,
right,
honest,
right.
She told me.
Right, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Right, Peggy, you start the first ticket.
Our Father art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us.
And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from
evil.
Amen. Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God,
pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death. Amen. Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death.
Amen. Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus.
I'm coming as fast as I can in these bags. So your bags.
Pop these off your
cup. What is it?
And don't be drawing attention to yourself.
But cigarette. What is it?
Cigarette.
But I don't smoke.
But I do. And if you want to keep your job, you keep quiet.
I don't like this.
Shush, suppress the passengers are coming on now. Sit there, be quiet.
Hello.
Sit here, Mammy.
Sit here.
Is it going to be rich?
I don't know.
Hello. Hello. Igor. Hello.
Hello.
Is that a row?
Sir, not me.
Have you anything I can declare, Mrs.?
Son, I'm not married. You don't call me Mrs.
Have you anything to declare, Miss?
No, no.
Can you stand up, Miss? No. Could you open your coat, Miss?
Sorry, but you're not searching me, dear. Then I'm going to have to get my superior officer, Mr. Kellum.
You can get whoever you like, but you're not laying a finger on me.
What's that man going to do here? You're a little searchy, Mammy.
I have
Lady Pettinger
on the
page.
She's refusing to be
searched,
but she looks suspicious, and I think
she's
smuggled.
I say, lead the way.
This is the lady in question.
Mrs., be reasonable. I'm only doing my job. I have to search you.
You are not searching me.
I'm going to ask you once more time, madam. I have to search you.
I'm telling you, you are not laying one finger on me.
Then I'll have no choice. I'm going to have to derail this train and that she'll be remained here for questioning.
Well, you do whatever you have to do, but you are not laying a finger on me.
I'll see you in court. I'm sorry, ladies. This train is off for the evening.
Well, I have to be in Derry for 10 o'clock. How are we going to get home?
Well, you may try and get a train and later on in the evening. This one is off for the night.
Oh, did you hear that?
Can I go?
Yes.
Can we go?
Yes. All except the two in the front.
And my baby gonna die. Let that bad suit you, baby.
What does that mean?
It means one part of the train stays here and the other part can go to Derry.
So do we go?
We go.
Do they not go?
They don't go, they have to stay. No. Oh, we got away with Vera. There are more cigarettes and they're in your bag.
Or I might find you in contempt of court.
I'm sorry, Your Honour. My client means no harm.
Very well. Has the jury reached a verdict?
Yes, we find him guilty as charged.
Right. I now take charge £100. Case closed. I'm sorry.
Are you playing cards?
No, we're not playing.
Kellen, do you want to play this?
We're doing. Well,
I'll bring the book.
You're all Kellen.
Don't you be cheating. You always cheat.
No, I'm not cheating.
Snap!
I never told him you were smoking.
That's because you were smoking.
I didn't tell him.
Did she not? She does. She's a nice delay, aren't you?
Your case has been dropped from £100 to a penny. Your husband has been paying it. So I'm returning at 7 and 5 pence. Good day.
Family, a massive thank you, because we really enjoyed the story. I know some parts were funny, but it was a pleasure to dramatise that story. I kept saying that to Josie as well. It was an absolute pleasure. And £100 back in the 40s. Like, my parents needed £100 25 years ago for a deposit for a house. So going like 60 years ago, that was big money. They're an amazing bunch of women, absolutely brilliant. But can I also thank the staff of the Millennium Forum. The stage crew is my youth theatre from the Waterside, from my own grandfather. Yeah. And the only hiccup of the night was the sound system. The system, not me, but sure, at least I made the mistakes. And I don't know whether it's anything to do with West Ham, but the song that wouldn't play was Forever Blowing Bubbles. I'm a Hammers fan, I wasn't supposed to play it. I'll put it down to that. So there's refreshments out in the far car room now, and you can have a chat. Get their autographs, sign them. This is only the beginning, all right, of the happy-go-luckies. We will be back in September.
She's worth it, she's worth it.
Pack up all my care and woe. Here I go, singing low. Bye bye, blackbird. Where somebody waits for me, sugar sweet, so is he. Bye bye. Hard luck stories they all hand me. Make my bed and light the light. I'll arrive late tonight. Blackbird, bye bye.
Blackbird, blackbird, singing the blues all day. Right outside of my door.
The sun and the rain, or its lovely promise won't come true. To each his own, to each his own, and my own is you. What good is a song if the words just don't belong? And a dream must be a dream for two. No good alone, to each his own. For me, there's you. If a flame is to grow, there must be a glow to open each door. There's a key. I need you, I know. I can't let you go. Your touch means too much to me. Two lips must insist on two more to be kissed, or they'll never know what love can do. To each his own, I found my own, one and all. Again, don't know where, don't know when, but I know we'll meet again some sunny day. Keep smiling through, just like you always do, till the blue skies drive the dark clouds far away. So will you please say hello to the folks that I know? Tell them I won't be long. They'll be happy to know that as you saw me go, I was singing this song. Again, don't know where, don't know when, but I know we'll meet again some sunny day.
Yeah.
this has been a WEA project, and the WEA is the Workers' Educational Association. And over the last 3 years, their funding has been for older people learning, so it's for 50 plus groups. And they deliver projects, drama, dance, history, digital photography, digital story making. The list goes on, and it's to get older people back into education again. And unfortunately, my sidekick and boss and best buddy couldn't be. Sinead Devine is the coordinator for the Derry branch, and Sinead couldn't be here tonight. Sinead's father passed away this week, so I've sorely missed her tonight, I can say that. I've been working with the group for 20 weeks, and we started off, it's a reminiscence piece. The story says all, okay? It's based on one of our fine actors. It's based on her mother, all right, Mrs. McLaughlin. It's a fantastic story. So I just want to ask you to turn off your mobiles or put them in silent. Rascals. Good on you. And I've always wanted to do this. The exits are here, here, that's it. Okay, so just remember when you're watching this production, this is the first time these ladies have ever been on stage. And it's not just one character. I haven't even been on stage where I've played 2 and 3 characters before. The majority of them have all doubled and tripled in characters. So they're going from playing like a 5-year-old to a 65-year-old. So that's a hard job on its own. So just remember that and respect them and enjoy the show. Thank you.
Were bulky.
You say you recognized him. How?
I
recognising me for this just before because you've caught stealing £20 worth of butter.
Objections, objections, my lord. You wanted to get that out and prejudice this woman.
Had he not asked certain questions in cross-examination, he may not have made that statement. You mean malignant action, Mrs. Darling.
You might not have understood. We live some unsupply year informed, and that denies all knowledge of this case.
Very well. I am imposing a £3 fine, allowing 1 month for payment. Next case.
I call Liam Callaghan to the stand.
Would you like to hand the Bible? Raise your right hand. Do you swear to tell the truth, the whole truth, and nothing but the truth? Well, help you God.
I do.
Please be seated.
Do you recognise the lady in question, Mr. Callaghan?
Yes, I do.
How do you know her?
On the 14th of November, I was searching a train, travelling to Derry from Fong. I saw that lady in the compartment with a child.
Did she have anything concealed?
I put it to her that she had concealed goods in her, but she denied this.
Did she agree to get searched?
She objected to being searched by a lady searcher, saying that she knew her rights and that she was confronted by a customs officer from Derry to submit not to doing it because it was illegal.
Many members of the public do not understand what the rights of customs officials are.
That's correct.
I understand that there are a lot of people that don't understand what the understand the question. Have you experienced any problems when you're searching people on the train?
Yes.
And people in a certain station of life?
The majority submit willing to do it.
And what? Can you explain what did happen?
Maggie, would you take a wee snuff?
Sure, I'll take a wee snuff.
I'm going to have to put on a pile of spots and see you later, Gary.
Thank you, Rosie.
You're
not surprised.
We're drying the washing.
I think that's going to be dried. No time up on there, Blaine.
Well, Maggie. If you lend me your washboard, I could get all the washing done today, and it will be dry in no time.
Aye, no bother, Mona, for now, get it.
That's great. Can I protect that tonight? I'll be saying
any time. It's a pretty good to get me stubborn for your head.
No, not stubborn.
Hey, Alec! And slay you in the dishes.
Okay, Mama.
Right, we're going to say the rosary now, and we're offering it up for your granny who's in hospital, and for Marianne that she has a wee, or get your wee message tonight.
I know what her message is, she's giving a bit me. She told me.
Will you stop that day now?
Mammy, honest. She told me. You did, Peggy. You told me. She told me.
Right, that's
Mommy,
right,
honest,
right.
She told me.
Right, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Right, Peggy, you start the first decade.
Our Father, art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us.
And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from
evil.
Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou among women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners, now and at the hour of our death.
Holy Mary, Mother of God, pray for us sinners now and at the hour of our death.
Mary, full of grace, the Lord is with thee. Blessed art thou amongst women, and blessed is the fruit of thy womb, Jesus. Holy Mary, Mother of God,
smoke.
But I do. If you want to keep your job, you keep quiet.
I don't like to.
Shush, the press the passengers is coming on now. Sit there, be quiet.
Hello.
Oh, hello.
Hello.
Sit here, Mammy.
Sit here.
Is it going to be rich?
I don't know. Oh, hello. Hello. You there? Hello.
Hello.
Is that a rope?
Sit down.
You don't call me Mrs.
Have you anything to declare, Miss?
No, no.
Could you stand up, Miss? Could you open your coat, Miss? What then?
But I don't smoke.
Oh, it's the selling then?
No, no, don't sell it, no. No.
What is your name? Where do you live?
22 Cleo Lane.
Oh, 22 Cleo Lane.
She's a bit slow.
You what? You will be here for Christmas.
Have you anything to declare?
No.
Could you stand up, miss? I'm going to have to search you.
I'm sorry, but you're not searching me, dear.
Then I'm going to have to get my superior officer, Mr. Kell.
You can get whoever you like, but you're not laying a finger on me.
What's that man going to do here? You should have let him search you, mammy.
I have a lady passenger on the plane. She's refusing to be searched, but she looks suspicious, and I think she's smuggled.
I say, lead the way.
This is the lady in question.
Mrs., be reasonable. I'm only doing my job. I have to search you.
You are not searching me.
I'm going to ask you once more time, madam. I have to search you.
I'm telling you, you are not laying one finger on me.
Then I'll have no choice. I'm going to have to derail this train and that she'll be remained here for questioning.
But you do whatever you have to do, but you are not laying a finger on me.
I'll see you in court. I'm sorry, ladies. This train is off for the evening.
Well, I have to be in Derry for 10 o'clock. How are we going to get home?
Well, you may try and get a train and later on in the evening. This one is off for the night.
Oh, did you hear that? Can
I go?
Yes.
Can we go?
Yes. All except the two in front.
What does that mean?
It means one part of the train stays here and the other part can go to Derry.
So do we go?
We go.
Do they not go?
They don't go, they have to stay. No. Oh. We got away with Vera. There are more cigarettes and they're your bag.
Or I might find you in contempt of court.
I'm sorry, Your Honour. My client means no harm.
Very well. Has the jury reached a verdict?
Yes, we find the penitent guilty as charged.
Right. I now charge £100. Case closed.
I'm sorry.
Sorry, mammy.
I'll get that.
I never told him you were smoking.
That's because you were smoking.
I didn't tell
him. Did you not? No. She's a nice delay, anyway.
Your kiss has been dropped from £100 to a penny. Your husband has been paying it. So I'm returning at 7 and 5 pence.
And David.
I kill that man!
Sugar and ice, nuts and raisins, honey and spice.